Anyway, and last but not least, you have access to the hottest discussions on the forum. So these are the key conversations, the key topics being discussed the most at the moment. You might be interested in taking part in it, right?
So, Brother Guillaume, I already know what will be the hottest discussion when we'll start the page again.
I'm scared to know. Go ahead. Which one is it?
No, it will be about why we're down and why we're bad and why we sinned. So
let's concentrate on the redemption process today. We need to gain the redemption of users.
Definitely, let's do that.
I think we are done with the welcome page, brother. And I think the next key step is to move to the game's catalog. Assistant Monk, please move to the game's catalog.
It's like the turtle in the logo language.
You're right. Mm-hmm. So as I explained before, the gaming catalog is organized, classified, depending on the gaming genres. So you are free to pick any gaming genre you like. And once you have picked a genre, for example, I don't know, adventure games or whatsoever, you are free to customize the way you want to browse the catalog. As you can see, you have many filters which you can fully customize. I will give you an example. It's not possible to specify the game modes you are interested in. Maybe you want to play this game on your own because you like single player games. Maybe you would like to know if the game has a co-op mode or multiplayer mode. Feel free to use the pick list, customize, and see the results on a real-time basis. These are for the filters. One more thing. On the left side, you have a search field. This search field is something we call the instant search bar. Why instant? Because it's fully dynamic. You just type a few letters, and in real time, you have the results appearing. This is exactly what the other guys from, I forgot the name, Google. Google. The guys from Google have done like 2 or 3 weeks ago, right?
Uh-huh.
As you can see, our monastery is very fashionable, and we are already at the very top of the trend, right?
Actually, I never heard of them.
Anyway, these are for the key features of the gaming catalog. As you can see, some titles are grayed out, right? These are the titles that have already been bought. If you want to buy other games appearing in the search results, you can put the mouse over the game and you will be able instantly to add the game to your cart or to your wishlist. This is very convenient, very easy, and once again, this is simple. Simplicity is good, brother, right?
Yeah, sort of.
Okay, brother, you're boring today. Anyway, from the games catalog, now it's time to move on to the new product page.
Finally, Brother Guillaume.
Finally.
I hope we'll not bore our viewers to that. So please wrap it up and let's get to the surprise we have for them.
I think we should move on to Fallout Tactics, right? This is...
This is my favorite game.
That's your favorite game?
Yes, that's my favorite game.
Right.
I know I shouldn't be playing that as a monk, but I still like it.
And I think we should remain neutral for the publishers, you know?
Oh yeah, sorry. I also like other games.
We like all the games on GOG. All the games are fantastic. It's obvious.
But without the bad ones, you know, the ones that...
The two ones
about.
You mentioned, yeah. You're right, brother. So the brand new product page, guys. What do we have there? We have many cool new small things. First of all, we have a brand new area, which is called What's Cool About This Game. What is this? It's a quick, brief overview of the game you are checking at the moment. 3 bullet points made by gamers for gamers and explaining you why this game is appealing to you. Is it some kind of marketing blah blah, brother?
Yeah, actually that's what I wanted to say, that a lot of pages of other platforms and stores are full of marketing blah blah. And here is the essence. It's written by gamers, by our testers, by people who know these games by heart and play them from A to Z, and this is what they think about these games.
Indeed, our testers have of course tested all the games from A to Z, and they had time to grasp the essence of every game, so they know what they talk about. So the 3 bullet points they have specified for every game is really the key core message made by gamers for gamers. We believe you will like it. Something else. As you know, on GOG, we are bundling every game with 3 exclusive goodies. And this is something we wanted to make more visible. So right now, we have a gray area on the product page where all the goodies are extremely visible. In the case of Fallout, you have free world papers, manuals, avatars,
the Fallout Bible,
manuals, anything. These are the key added value from GOG.
Actually, I think,
do you know many monasteries giving so many goodies, Martin?
No, I don't. I actually don't. And what I wanted to say is that the word goodies doesn't give it justice. This is exclusive content. This is normally what you would get in a collector's edition. Whenever we have an option, we always put it out for you, and you get it for free when you purchase the game. That really works great.
I fully agree, brother. Something else which is quite important. We have tested all our games to ensure they are Windows 7 compatible. This has taken quite some time, and the conclusions are as following. Over 150 games are fully compatible with Windows 7. They are working on any configuration running on Windows 7. What about the other games, you may ask? It's not that they are not working, they are working. They are working on most configurations. But there are a few isolated cases we have to address, a few bugs we have to fix. And on GOG, just like any religion, right, we have some principles we cannot escape from. And full compatibility is one of the key values on GOG.
Brother, it's even an obsession.
It's an obsession, you are right. So those remaining games are still being tested to be fixed for the few isolated configurations causing troubles. And once we have reached a sufficient level of confidence, they will be flagged as Windows 7 compatible. So please count on us, brothers. Please realize that we will be testing more and more games. And when we fix some games, you will be the first ones to be informed. I believe other platforms are paying a lot less attention to the compatibility of product. I have one platform in mind. I will not give the name. I don't want to sound bitter. This is so lame and so weak. But there is one platform in particular. They don't give a damn about compatibility, right? And this is bad. We have to gain the faith of users, and we will be working on it heavily. Right, brother?
Yes, brother. Let's move on to the other features. Continue, brother, please.
Yeah, brother. So one key new feature in the upper right corner. Finally, we have a like button for Facebook. Everybody likes Facebook. That's the biggest monastery out there.
So that's sort of funny. Like button, like Facebook. It's like rhyming.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's really cool, it's cool. Yeah.
I'm a cool monk, you know. So yeah, if you like a game, why not clicking the like button and let your friends know about it? You have now the occasion to spread your tastes. That's a cool opportunity,
and
right?
And support our monastery.
And support our monastery. Yeah, there is a bit of marketing inside and so on. Isn't religion about marketing? No. This is getting controversial. Let's stop here.
Brother Guillaume,
let's stop here.
Let's not get fanatical.
Let's stop here. I don't want to harm any sensitive people. One more thing.
The download time.
Exactly. We are a download platform, right? We are a digital download platform. So you might be wondering how much time it's going to take to have the game on your hard drive. So now we have a download calculator. It's basically a slide bar where you have to specify the connection speed you have at home, and automatically you can see how much time it's gonna take, how much time you're gonna have to wait impatiently, dying, crying, before the game lands on your hard drive. This is quite cool.
Brother Guillaume, I would recommend right now moving directly to the community section and then coming back to the...
Actually, brother, you're going too fast. I can see you didn't learn your Bible by heart. There is one more thing we have to talk about. There is one more thing. I would be fast. If you go at the very bottom of the product page, you will realize that there are three main channels to jump from a product to another. There are three main channels to browse the catalog. The first one is customers who bought this game also bought blah, blah, blah. What is blah, blah, blah? Have to be a bit more... precise, right? Blah, blah, blah is not enough. It's very simple. If you bought Fallout Tactics, many games are similar. Many people have bought similar games, and you have to be informed about this. You might like Fallout Tactics, you might like something else. You have the occasion to see other products. The second channel to jump from one product to another, if the game is belonging to a series, and Fallout Tactics is belonging to a series, you are automatically informed about the games which are belonging to the series. In the case of Fallout Tactics, you are automatically